Hi there. I'm Marcus Yam, technology evangelist at Intel. We recently hosted a Reddit AMA talking about 12th gen Intel Core H series processors, codenamed Alder Lake H. So, you know what that means. Welcome to the Intel Tech Community Mailbag. First, a little background. Alder Lake H is the codename for 12th gen Intel Core H series processors. These are chips meant for high performance laptops focused on gaming, creativity, and to achieve peak performance and efficiency, Alder Lake H utilizes the performance hybrid architecture that has come to define Intel's 12th gen processors. For this segment, that's up to 14 cores comprised of 6 performance cores, or P cores, and 8 efficient cores, or E cores, capable of up to 20 threads. At the top of the stack is the Core i9-12900HK, the fastest mobile CPU Intel's ever made, and the world's best mobile gaming platform, featuring performance gains of up to 40% over previous generations. Let's get to the mailbag. Oof. Sounds heavy. Okay, what we got? Oh, that's lucky. All of these questions are asking for the same thing. Kasmodin, Uzi38, and Bionic Squash all want one thing. Shots. Let's do it. Oh, wait, what's that? Not those type of shots? Oh, die shots? Well, here you go. Drink it in. By the way, I share your enthusiasm for these beautiful die shots. I love the Alder Lake design so much that I had this t-shirt custom printed with a die shot. And if there's enough interest from the rest of you, we might make some more in a limited edition run. Sound off in the comments below. We'd love to make dreams come true at Intel Tech, provided your dream involves a t-shirt with a die shot of Alder Lake. If you're just looking for a wallpaper for your desktop, check that out in the description below. Right, the next one. Manuku asks, what was your biggest challenge for 12th gen H series? Great question, Manuku. Since your question deals with challenges, I figure I'll attempt the hardest thing I can possibly imagine for the answer. The biggest challenge by far, making performance hybrid and thread director work seamlessly. Moving from homogeneous to a heterogeneous core architecture was an enormous challenge in the software model across firmware, OS, and even developers. It's just the beginning, of course. Deeper integration between hardware and software with Thread Director opens up incredible power performance opportunities for the future. All right, let's try this. Hey, all right. The Malcor asks, do mobile Alder Lake processors differ from their desktop counterparts in the way they direct work to the small cores? So, Thread Director for H series and S series are similar. Thread Director for P series and U series have additional optimizations for power savings since those processes are for thin and light laptops. Let's see what's next. Wait. Hey, I remember this username. Titanic Freak wants to know, is there any reason you guys decided to give the 45 watt chips the full 96 EU configuration of Iris Xe graphics? Also, will there be any Alder Lake H laptops without the DGPU? To answer this question, let me grab my SKU table. As you can see here, the 12th gen H series processors have the Iris Xe graphics with up to 96 EUs. There are several reasons for this. One is to enable architectural scalability with the rest of the mobile product line. Another is to enable the new Intel Deep Link feature with Intel Arc Discrete graphics. Finally, Intel wants to provide a 1080p gaming experience for 12th gen H series based systems that may ship without discrete graphics, which will also be appreciated on laptops with Intel U and P series for thin and light laptops. Oh, Bionic Squash asks this question. Do CPU cores on Alder Lake H processors use fiber? Nope. Alder Lake features discrete voltage regulation, which means no fully integrated voltage regulators will be necessary. Okay, what's next? Hey, Jackpot, put it all in black, says, no questions, just wanted to say thanks for taking the time to do Q&As with the Reddit community. Thanks, put it all in black. We've noticed that you never miss our AMA, and you have some really insightful questions. It's a pleasure to have you here, and a sincere thanks to you and everyone who participates in our AMAs and watches these videos. We really, really appreciate it. Bag's still heavy. Let's see what we got. Kasmodin asks, what is the range of wattage OEMs can control? Can they do a 35 watt Alder Lake H design? The short answer is yes. OEMs could design a 35-watt Alder Lake H if they want to. This is because 35 watts is the minimum system TDP or PL1 for 12th Gen H series. Still, the base power specification for Alder Lake H is 45 watts. This is where many designs will be configured and where the sustained performance is very efficient. Right, let's go. Looks like we have a two-parter here. First, David Beppo asks, does Alder Lake H still feature the limited overclocking Tiger Lake H i7 and higher SKUs have? In 12th Gen H series, we have no partial unlock SKUs, and only our i9-12900HK has full overclocking available. And David Beppo has another question. A lot of launch reviews have shown regressed battery life versus previous gen. Is this expected, or could there have been an issue with the models or even reviews? 12th Gen H series package power is actually improved versus 11th Gen H series due to in-package PCH and various firmware software optimizations for a given workload. System battery life is a function of many factors, including SoC, graphics, panel, memory, software OS, etc., and will vary by device and test configuration. I can't address specific review scenarios here in this video, but the goal of 12th Gen was to greatly increase performance over the previous generation while holding steady battery life. All right. Hey, look at that. Just when I need a little pick-me-up. Oh, and it looks like there's a question written on here. Coffee Blowout asks, will all H45 series Alder Lake laptops support undervolting with XTU or TS or only the 12900HK? Among the 12th Gen H series processors, only the 12900HK support undervolting, as you need overclocking to be enabled in order to undervolt. It's the OEM's choice if they want to enable it on their 12900HK systems. It's pretty good. Feels like I'm just starting to get into the groove. Let's see who's next. Uzi38 asks, traditionally, with mobile processors boost, algorithms tend to favor a more race-to-idle approach to try and keep the SoC power-gated for as long as possible. With the heterogeneous architecture and previous slides showing that at higher frequencies, Gracemont's power efficiency tends to fall apart compared to Golden Cove. What's the plan for handling background tasks when idle? Will the priority be on high-performance cores to handle them as quickly as possible, or is the old race-to-idle approach less useful when you could instead leverage the Gracemont cores at low power? Great question. You're really showing a lot of familiarity with the subject. Let me see if I can answer you in a similar level of detail. Now, race to idle is still a very relevant for bursty or high QoS quality of service tasks, such as opening an application. RTI, or race to idle, however, does not comprehend workload importance. Many opportunistic tasks may keep racing. Performance hybrid architecture with Intel Thread Director allows background and low QoS applications to be moved to the E cores in coordination with OS policies, including the user-selected power mode in Windows 11. This is ideal for optimizing energy expenditure of long-running, non-performant work while also preserving the P cores for high-priority tasks. Bag's getting a little lighter. We must only have a few left. Oh, you guys know how to keep me on my toes. Hi-Fi Hedgehog asks, without mentioning any partner names, do you have any tablet PCs, detachable in the style of the Microsoft Surface Pro line, lined up that will be using your U-Series processors? Oh, I've got something to show you. I know you're asking about U-Series, so you'll have to keep your eyes peeled for those new products, but since this is an AMA on H-Series, I want you all to see this. This is an H-Series tablet from Asus called the ROG Flow Z13. I call it that because I'm Canadian, but you may know it as the Z13. This thing is super cool. It's got a Core i9-12900H that's with up to 14 cores and 20 threads, all in this tablet form factor. And this is just one of my favorite new designs. What's that? Looks like a special delivery. Ah, another two-parter. Let's see here. AHM asks, will we have the option to park or disable P cores to improve battery life, or does it happen automatically? Well, AHM, Thread Director and the operating system may autonomously and dynamically park cores to ensure efficient operating in both active performance and power-saving scenarios. Oh, not quite like that. Next question. How does battery life compare to last gen? From the reviews, some are better and some are worse than Tiger Lake. 11th Gen Evo systems still offer great battery life today, and the 12th Gen mobile SoC power is similar to 11th Gen. The primary design goal this generation was driving significant increases in performance for all workload types, single-threaded and multi-threaded, sustained and burst, across the entire product line. Hope that helps. Only a few more left. Oh, what's this? Oh, tasty. What's Your Spaghetti wants to know. Can you clarify the deep learning boost? 12th gen Intel Core desktop and mobile processors support Intel Deep Learning Boost, or VNNI, across the family stack, with both the P cores and the E cores supporting execution of the Intel Deep Learning Boost instruction extensions. Some AI inference applications being used and available include CyberLink for photo deblur, XSplit for background removal, Nero for photo tagging, and others. And around 12 apps under engagement that allow specific applications to do image classification, object detection, background blur or removal, image and video upscaling, speech recognition, and language translation. I'm gonna save these for later. Oh, looks like there's a leftover here for our desktop AMA. Super Space AIDS asks, I'm doing a new PC build, so is there any chance of Cryo coming to 12th gen? If need be, I'll go 11th, but rather do 12 because it's going to be a sub-zero build. Yes, in the time between the AMA and when you see this video, our cooler partners will have released new designs for the LJ 1700 sockets. So enjoy your sub-zero 12th gen build. Wow, I can't believe it, but looks like we're finally on our last question. Let's see what we've got here. Reddit user DLeaded asks, what do you think about the future of upgradable and user repairable laptops in this age of planned obsolescence? I mean, we now see much more soldered parts like LPDDR standards, and also soldered GPUs instead of MXM. It's great that the industry as a whole is moving towards a more friendly, upgradable, and user repairable age. And yes, moving the whole industry in this direction will take some time and collaboration, but I think we're taking the first steps towards that as an end goal. For example, there is an ongoing collaboration with Dell under Project Luna that explores laptop design ideas to make components more accessible, replaceable, and reusable. Huh. That was fun. Well, friends, that wraps up our Alder Lake H community mailbag. Thank you all so much again to everyone who submitted questions. You all make this such a fun community to be a part of. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe to the Intel Tech channel on YouTube, and go ahead and give us a follow on Twitter. And I'll join you in the next AMA. Thanks so much. See you again. All right, let's try this. All right.